The Dead Space Action Director is a tool within the new Dead Space remake that I from now on want to see in every horror game remake and or just, you know, survival horror game in general. Why? Because it makes the survival horror the greatest it has ever been, even on repeated playthroughs, through designed randomness. Okay, let me paint a picture for you. You're playing Resident Evil 2 for the first time, and the game instills you with this fear of the unknown, right? Because you don't know what's going to be happening around any corner. Will you become confident, or will you slow down your approach and try to conserve as much ammo as possible? While juggling the different puzzle pieces, overall, this main type of tension is what Resident Evil taps into for your first playthrough. Subsequently, when you're ready to experience New Game Plus, the harder difficulty modes add challenges to usually some enemy placements and maybe some damage modifiers, but the main challenge just becomes about conserving ammo and planning ahead. But that original dread, the tension of the unknown, is essentially scrapped in favor of figuring out how to circumvent a lot of the obstacles. It's less survival horror and becomes more of like a weird parkour puzzle. The goal and fun comes in creating a speedrun that is essentially just a clean, perfect dance of all the elements of the game, right? And that is a very cool thing that has existed for many years now. But Resi 2 kind of introduced a little bit of a new wrench into this system. Mr. X, a dynamic stalker enemy that can chase you around in like a whole map area. This created a little bit of a sense of randomness, a bit of noise if you will. But eventually, of course, down the line, you'll pretty quickly figure out that hey, he's only one variable in the game, he can't enter certain rooms, etc. Okay, time to get to my point, right? What if I say that the Dead Space remake solves this slight issue of predictable replayability by essentially introducing possible random encounters on top of the encounters that are crafted for you to fight? A whole new set of possible or not encounters that can trigger if you walk through a room, backtrack, revisit, or explore. The Ishimura is infested, and you hear the noises and crawling in the walls. Only now, it is also possible something might effectively pop out. A random bathroom might not be anything special, but if you come back there because maybe you forgot to pick something up or you forgot if you even looked in that room, it might trigger an event where some characters do spawn and you have to fight for your life. This randomness might upset some people that want to create the perfect speedrun, but in my opinion, I think it heightens the fear of the unknown to constantly keep you fully immersed and on your toes. I can definitely attest that up until the end of the game, Dead Space had me on my toes because I knew in the back of my mind that even though I had explored an area and cleared it out all the way, that did not necessarily mean that the area was going to be free of any new enemies, possibly making their way inside through either the vents or whatever. It felt organic, as if the world had truly gone to shit. Is it similar to how enemies respawn in a certain area in regular games? I think there is a difference in the fact that it's not guaranteed. For a lot of older titles, if areas had respawning enemies, you would know that they would always be respawning. However, here, it is much more of a, well, maybe a room that never even had any enemies to begin with might be a room where you encounter enemies, right? And with a horror game that mainly tackles the survival horror genre within that niche, there is no safety in where you want to conserve your ammo. You are going to be forced to make the most of what you have. And you know, necromorphs will always drop money, so there's always a bit of a return on investment, even though what you're getting back is probably not really what you've pumped into them. My point being that just the idea of a randomized encounter system like this totally heightens, for me, the constant fear factor throughout the game. As in, you will be constantly on your toes and stressed out, and that artificial stress, I think, is a really good thing when you're creating a horror game where you want to be immersed in the idea that you're one person against the world, not knowing what could be lurking around the corner. Take care, guys, and don't forget to subscribe.